Worthy to pray thankfully, our Father who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us, lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. Christ Jesus our Lord, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. This lecture was prepared mainly for the fathers, for the clergy, but when Abuna Armi asked me to give the same lecture, so maybe you will find some notes in the PowerPoint presentation meant to the clergy, but we can apply it also for any Sunday school servant. Many times when we deal with our children in service, we feel uncomfortable in dealing with them. So sometimes we become tense, sometimes we become angry, sometimes we become judgmental, sometimes we become harsh, or maybe you want to avoid them. So how you deal with your students, especially when you feel uncomfortable, that's what we're gonna speak about it. Yes, there are people who are not godly, not obedient, and they are not also extreme difficult cases. And many of us, we don't feel comfortable with them. and struggle in dealing with them. We like when the student is compliant, obedient. When we give him assignment, he will do it. When we ask him to participate in certain activity, he will do it, etc. And usually we ask questions like, should I be firm with them or kind? Should I isolate them to protect the rest of the youth, or should I allow them to interact with the other students in class? How I can discipline them? So, who are they? Who are they? These people that most of the time we don't feel comfortable around them. Number one, people whom I dislike for one reason or another. Most of us, sometimes you see a person in your class and you feel comfortable around him. And sometimes people in your class, you don't feel comfortable around them. And you don't have any explanation. Just you don't feel comfortable around this person. Maybe your intuition, chemistry, whatever. The second group, people who are not compliant to my personal views. For example, I have a certain vision how my class should go. I have a certain vision about the activities in the class. And the people usually argue with me, tell me, no, we should not do it this way, we should do it this way. So give me hard time. So I do not feel comfortable with these people because they are not compliant. They are not, yes, sir, we will do it. Yeah, that's beautiful, that's good. Some people who have strong personalities or opinionated, again, they are out loud, spoken. Many times they have good logic and they actually argue with me with this good logic, and sometimes I don't know how to convince them. So I feel uncomfortable around these people. Sometimes I don't feel comfortable around people who are sinners. All of us who are sinners, but I mean by sinners here, people who are not living the life of repentance. For example, a person who is living in sexual immorality and he does not want to end these relationships. A person who is doing drugs, a person who goes to nightclubs, a person who has dual life. And I don't feel comfortable around them. And also, I can be concerned about the other youth and their influence on the other youth in the class. Another group, people whom I perceive as trouble and division makers, or offenders or rebellious sinners. For example, person in my class who actually, because of his strong personality, he can attract certain group to be his group and isolate another group. So we can call this person a troublemaker or divisive because he doesn't include everyone in the class. Or a person who is making a group against me. So now this person and his group and me with the rest of the class. Or person who causes trouble all the time, hits this guy and make conflict with this guy and curse this guy. So they are causing conflict all the time. Sometimes these people, yani we wish in Huma they don't come to the class. And when they don't come to the class, we'll be happy. Alhamdulillah, nahar da magoosh, irtahna minhum. Taban, this should not be a feeling of a Sunday school servant, and how to be happy when one of your class does not show up. And how most of us react to these people. First reaction, isolation and avoidance. And sometimes I warn other students, I warn other youth, and into to be careful in dealing with this person. So by this warning, I'm isolating him. Or I warn parents of our students to be careful in dealing with this person. And maybe I will not call or encourage this person to come. If he's absent, I will not ask about him. If he doesn't show up, I am not gonna visit him, because I am more comfortable when he is not here. When he comes, actually he causes problems. That's why I want just to isolate him and to avoid him. مثلاً, if there is مؤتمر, convention, I don't want him to come, because if he comes, he will cause a lot of tension and trouble. And sometimes I say that's discipline, and I try to cover up my lack of comfort with a virtue. Another reaction is to treat them differently or to discriminate against them. Discrimination can be as simple as you don't smile in their face. يعني when you see other student, هاي ازيك يا فلان تاخده كده في حضنك طبطب عليه تاني هاي كده ف it can be يعني discrimination, it can be just as simple as you are not just welcoming him as the rest of the class, or it can be take many forms. If there are activities, you don't actually let him participate in these activities. You don't choose him. If you're going to choose some people, for example, in choir, to do certain activity, you are not going to choose this person. فهو يحس كده ان there is a different treatment from Sunday school servant toward him. Another reaction is to treat them with harshness, harsh comments and harsh stand. انت بقى مش هتبطل, انت عامل لنا وجع في الكلاس, انت دايما بيجي لنا مشاكل منك, دايما مش عارف ايه, انت هتعقل كده تبقى كويس. نفضل كده على طول to give him harsh comments, and sometimes these comments come with anger. I'm angry, so actually I'm expressing these angers in my comment to him. Gossip can be also another reaction. I talk about them with others and ruin their reputation, not for the purpose of seeking advice how to deal with them, but just I'm gossiping about them. مثلاً, if anyone in my class speaks about this person, فأنا أقول له ده متعب وده بيعمل مشاكل وده من يعني من ساعة ما دخل الكلاس وعمل كذا وعمل كذا, وأفضل يعني أتكلم كلام has no value except to ruin the reputation of this person. They can take your words as reference. يقول له حتى الخادم بتاعنا في الكنيسة قال عليه كذا وكذا وكذا. ف your words will be reference about how bad he is. Or مثلا دايما when I give examples in the lessons that I am teaching, in my mind this person, so I describe his actions. بحيث يعني everyone in the class knows I'm talking about him. فيبقى as if I am preaching about this person in all my lessons. What are some underlying reasons why I am not comfortable with these people? Number one can be insecurity. I feel threatened by them or by their abilities. مثلا لو انا عندي ولد زي ما قلت very smart, strong personality, other students like him and love him, and he is actually a leader, so I feel intimidated by him. I feel he can, يعني with his opinion or with his argument, he can actually he has more influence on the rest of the class than me. فأنا ببقى متضايق منه. I don't feel secure around him. I am not comfortable around him. Another thing is my ego. My ego, مثلا, if it doesn't comply with something I said to them, if he start مثلا certain activity without مثلا telling me. يعني مثلا لو انت بتدرس مثلا كلاس في هاي سكول وبعد كده عندك واحد ولد من الولاد اللي هم في سكول حافظ ألحان كويس and maybe he knows hymns more than you. فمثلا اتنين تلاتة من أصحابه قالوا له حفظنا اللحن ده ولا حاجة زي كده, فابتدى ياخدهم عنده البيت ويحفظهم اللحن ده. انت بقى اتضايقت, هو ما عملش حصة ألحان في الكنيسة ولا حاجة, ده حاجة كده, بس انت اتضايقت اللي تقول how he does this without telling me. هنا what bothers you is your ego, is your pride. بدل ما انت to encourage him ان هو كويس انه بيحفظ لأصحابه كده, no, انت you are bothered, وممكن تقول له no, you need to stop this. عارفين زي القصة بتاعت يوحنا الحبيب, John the beloved, when he said to the Lord Jesus Christ, we saw someone who is casting out demons in your name, but he is not following us, so we forbid him. ربنا قال له why you forbid him? If he is not against us, then he is with us. Why did you forbid him? Some servants are very controlling personalities. As you want to control everything in the class, everyone in the class. When you have like a person who is strong in his personality, or a person who is leader by nature, maybe it will be difficult to control him. So once you feel that this person is not under your control and he does things differently, this will bother you. Because in your heart you want just to control everything. And being a controlling personality, this can be a challenge in service in general, because you will care about control more about the benefit of the service. You will care about how everyone should submit to you more than the benefit of the whole service. ممكن يكون the underlying reason what we call it spiritualization. Spiritualization means you are taking a spiritual stand from outside. Although from inside, you are not at that spiritual level. Let me give you an example. مثلا لو جي واحد شتمك, the spiritual stand ان انت to forgive him and to قول الله يسامحك. بس لو انت internally you are not at that level and you are not striving to be at that level, but just because انت خادم لازم ترد كده, فهتلاقي you build within you anger and bitterness towards this person. هتلاقي نفسك مش عايز تتعامل معه. ده like passive aggressive, يعني انت you are not aggressive with him, but passively you are not comfortable with him, so you are sending this message, and then I don't like you. طبعا الحل في النقطة دي مش انك تشتمه تقول لي if I'm not at the same spiritual level, but to be fighting the good fight and to ask the grace of God, تقول لي انا for your sake, ان انا I forgive him. For your sake, I did not repay evil with evil. But internally, I'm not at this spiritual level. Grant me your grace. So internally will be like externally. I don't want to be like hypocrite, or I want look like a spiritual while I'm not. But help me so internally can match what I did externally. Another reason, when you care more about rules more than caring about the person and his salvation. Of course, rules are very important, but we should know that rules are made for man, not man for rules. And I'm speaking here about especially the rules that are human, اللي احنا بنعملها. انت حطيت rule to the class مثلا. فمثلا انت فرضا حطيت rule to the class ان لو انت هتبتدوا class Sunday school مثلا 11:30, فتقول مثلا if anyone comes after 11:40 مش هيخش الكلاس. ده rule. فيجي واحد مثلا 11:45, فانت ممكن تبقى very firm معاه وتمنعه ان هو يخش الكلاس. وهنا انت تقول انا عايز كل حاجة تبقى منظمة وكل حاجة منضبطة وكده يعني. ويمكن الولد ده مثلا عنده عذر ان هو متأخر and he wants to attend, بس انت يعني تكسر خاطره and you don't show him love and acceptance in order not to break your rules. So you broke the commandment of God, which is the commandment of love, in order to keep your own rule, your own commandment. طبعا دي محتاجة wisdom and discernment. If I insist in هو ما يدخلش, why I'm insisting? How actually I deliver the message? احنا كلنا مثلا احنا ككهنه واسقفه لما حد بيجي بعد تحرير الخدام مثلا ما بنخليهوش يلبس. But how you deliver the message? Do you deliver the message in harshness or with love? فالكتب والفريسيين they cared more about rules than about the benefit of the people. So every time the Lord Jesus Christ performed a miracle on the Sabbath, they give him hard time. That's why the Lord told them, Sabbath made for man, not man for Sabbath. فربنا was not calling the people to break the commandment of Sabbath, because Sabbath one of the Ten Commandments. But he wanted them to know, when God gives the commandment of Sabbath, لما قال أذكر يوم الرب لتقدسه, while 6 days you work and you rest on the seventh day, this was for the benefit of the person, because our body needs rest, so it's for the benefit of the person, and also to give time to serve the Lord and to worship the Lord. So if God was healing somebody, it goes with the purpose of this commandment. God wants to have rest and to take care of our physical body. Why they are angry? Sabbath is made for man, not man made for Sabbath. ودي تمشي معها بقى man's commandment versus God's commandment. يعني many times احنا we break the commandment of God to keep our own commandments. We break the commandments of love or the commandments of humbleness or the commandments of forgiveness in order to keep our own commandments. So, محتاج ان انت to examine yourself carefully, which commandment you are keeping and which commandment you are breaking. Are you breaking the commandment of God or are you breaking your own commandment? That's very important. Also another point, underlying reason, sometimes we have personal issues. يعني إيه؟ يعني مثلا الخدام اللي فيكو مثلا كبار ومتجوزين وعندهم مثلا ولاد في هاي سكول وابنه تعبه في البيت. يعني if your son giving you hard time, فمثلا هفترض مثلا your son مطول شعره كده بطريقة انت مش عاجباك وكلمته وقلت له يا ابني احلق شعرك, المنظر ده مش كويس, ده كرونسوس الاولى 11 بتقول عيب للرجل ان هو يرخي شعره, وقعدت تكلمه وهو ما بيسمعلكش, فانت متغاظ منه, متغاظ من ابنك بالجسد. يعني تروح الكنيسه مثلا لو بتخدم نفس الكلاس في هاي سكول تلاقي نفسك متغاظ من كل العالم اللي طوله شعرها, بالك ما هي دين بقى ايه, انت هنا you project your discomfort with your son على كل الكلاس رمز remind you with your son, فتلاقي نفسك بقى ايه متضايق, واي واحد شكله كده تلاقي بتعامله وحش من غير اي سبب. So you need to be aware with your personal issues. If you have a personal issue with your son or with your daughter, try not to project this personal issue on the rest of the class in the church. Another point, اللي هي judgmental attitude. يعني although يعني I love our culture, the Egyptian culture very much, but for some reason those who grow in Egyptian culture, of course not all of them, but many of them actually, they have the judgmental attitude. They look at the negative. They judge what's negative. You cannot see what's positive, but you see what's negative in the others, and you judge them. And this judgment can appear in your eyes, can appear in the way you are dealing with the person. عشان كده كتير من ولادنا يقولوا إن مثلا most of the families of the church are judgmental. I don't want to go to the church because I will feel judged by the people in the church. We need to take care of this issue. لأن judgment is a sin. And to have a judgmental attitude, that is sinful. So we need actually نحن to stop and to have accepting and loving and forgiving attitude rather than the judgmental attitude. When the atmosphere in the church is therapeutic and healthy, actually this makes the repentance easy for the people, and to be transformed to the image of God can be easier. But when the atmosphere in the church is judgmental and negative, this actually will not help the people to repent. بالعكس هيعنتوا, and they will rebel more. This atmosphere is a pathological atmosphere, will not help the people to repent. And all of us are Sunday school servants, so my reaction, I have to justify it, and I have to justify it from the scripture. مثلا ميجي بوني يقول لي, why you are dealing harshly with this person? Why don't you show him love and compassion and acceptance? Definitely there is difference between accepting people and accepting sin. Big, big difference. And the Lord show acceptance to people, not to sins. فأنا, I need to have my justification. فأقول له, ممكن أقول لأبونا, أقول لأبونا ده a whole chapter in Matthew 23, ربنا in this chapter قاعد يقول woe to you, woe to you, woe to you. الويل لكم الويل لكم. فاحنا محتاجين ان احنا نبقى جداد, محتاجين ان احنا نبكي. Didn't St. Paul said to Timothy, rebuke, وبخ انتهر عز. So, وقال له, let no one despise your youth. فأخذ بقى الآيات دي to justify my reactions. وعارفين John and James, when one of the cities of Samaria closed the gates of the city in front of the Lord Jesus Christ. So if you want actually that fire comes from heaven to burn the two cities, and they justified their action, this harsh reaction, they justified it. قالوا زي ما Elijah did with the prophet, هم اللي كانوا 50 في 50, ونزلت نار من السماء وأكلتهم. ف sometimes we like to give to find justification from the Bible for your action. طب هنا ربنا did not accept this as justified action. وقال لهم I don't know from which spirit you are. The Son of Man did not come to destroy the world or to condemn the world. He came to save the world. He came to save the world. أحيانا برضو ناخد يوحنا المعمدان as an example. نقول يوحنا in his preaching was very sharp. كان يقول للناس كده vipers brood of serpents. ليه أبونا زعلان مني لما أنا باخد موقف شديد؟ يوحنا كان يقول لهم كده أيها الحياة أولاد الأفاعي, ليه أنا غلط لما أشخط في ولد ولا أخذ موقف معاه؟ And when I isolate a person, فأخذ الآية هنا First Corinthians chapter 5 verse 13, when St. Paul said, put away from yourselves the evil person, and in the same chapter he said, a small lump can live in the whole dough. فأنا I'm removing this small lump in order to protect the rest of the class. طبعا كل الآيات دي has explanation, and how to be applied needs discernment in order to apply it in the right context. واخدين بالكم؟ يعني مثلا لما St. Paul قال put away the evil person from among you, عمل ايه بعدها؟ عمل ايه؟ الأول, when you study 2 Corinthians, St. Paul wrote this excommunication with many tears, with many tears. قال بدموع كثيرة وكآبة قلب كتبت لكم. يعني he was not angry. ما مش زينا نقول لا, ما هو بولس قال أعزل الخبيث من بينكم, وبقى أنا متضايق كده وأنجري وعايز يعني أطلع كل الغضب اللي فيه في فلان. لا, ده كأب يعني بيعمل ده من أجل الخلاص بتاعه. فعلشان كده قال بكآبة قلب ودموع كثيرة كتبت لكم. وبعد كده the goal was therapeutic. يعني while he was doing the excommunication, the goal was therapeutic. قال تخلص الروح في يوم الرب, that his soul may be saved in the day of the Lord. So when I do discipline, I should ask myself, is it therapeutic or out of anger? What is the goal of this discipline? St. Paul was very clear in disciplining this person. He said that the soul may be saved in the day of the Lord. بعد كده القديس بولس عمل ايه بعدها؟ كان فرحان وهابي؟ No, he was not. They were like, إن انفتح لي باب في الرب. يعني there were doors opened for him for service. في أبواب اتفتحت للخدمة. يقول لك but I did not have rest in my soul. كان متضايق. يعني الواحد لما يجي ياخد قرار مع واحد صعب المفروض يبقى متضايق، المفروض ما يبقاش فرحان. بولس كده مش قادر يخدم. And then he sent Titus to check on them to see what's happened هناك. وكان مفروض يقابل تايتوس في ترواس. So he went to ترواس and there was many services for St. Paul. But since he did not find Titus, he did not have rest or peace in his soul. But then Finn finally was able to meet Titus. And Titus brought to him the good news that this person repented and all the church repented and they forgave him. فبولس راح قال, if you forgive him with anything, I forgive also. وبالعكس, they give him commandment. قال لهم, show him love lest he is swallowed from the grief. مكنوا له المحبة لألا يبتلع من الحزن المفرط. فأنت أخذت الآية دي وطلعتها ونسيت all the events around it. You forgot how Paul was crying with many tears when he wrote this communication. You forgot how Paul, although there were many services and many doors open for him, but you forgot how he did not have peace in his heart. You forgot he sent Titus to check on him and to check on the whole church. You forgot that when Titus actually brought the good news about his repentance, he immediately forgave him and absolved him. You forgot how he instructed the Holy Church to show him and to affirm to him their love, lest he is swallowed from grief. So don't take just one verse and take it out of the context. وتقول ما هو بولس الرسول قال, put away from yourselves the evil person. Here just you are taking verse from its context. عشان كده أنا قلت كل الآيات دي, yes, it's in the scripture. But to understand it, you need to understand it in the whole context. Don't take it outside the context. Another justification is the homily of St. John Chrysostom that we read in the Holy Week, when John Chrysostom said, and God planted the paradise not from good and bad trees but only from good trees. وعايز يقول ان في الكنيسة you need to keep only the good trees. If there is a bad tree you need to actually remove it. So we take this نور مهو جون كريزستون بيقول كده, بيقول ان الكنيسة should be only good trees not bad trees. But again you are taking this out of the whole context. أو واحد يجي مثلا يقول لك, طب shouldn't we discipline the people? Yes, we need to discipline them. But how to discipline them is another question, actually. So there are some facts we need to remember all the time. The first fact, the lost sheep ministry is very, very important for the Lord. Many times, احنا بنهتم بالولاد الكويسين الحلوين اللي بيحضروا كده. And the ministry of the lost sheep, yes, it's a challenging ministry. And many of us, we don't want actually to spend time مع الولد اللي بياخد drugs أو الولد اللي ما بيسمعش كلامنا أو الولد المشاكس. We don't want actually to spend time. It's tiring, challenging. You don't see fruit in it. So why I spend time in this? Rabbina, when he sends the disciples in the first time in Matthew chapter 10 verse 6, Allahum, go rather to the lost sheep of the house of Israel. We said in Messiah, in his ministry, he was looking for the lost. He said, I did not come to call righteous to repentance, but I came to call sinners. The whole do not need a physician, but the sick. St. John Chrysostom, who said in his homily that the church should be only from good trees, St. John Chrysostom said that the church is a hospital for the sinners and not a hotel for the saints. The church is a hospital for the sinners, nor a hotel for the saints. In Matthew 9, verse 12 and 13, Rabbana al, those who are well have no need of a physician, but those who are sick. But go and learn what this means. What this means. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. For I did not come to call the righteous but sinners to repentance. Rabbana ayiz mercy. Rabbana wants us to be merciful with others. I desire mercy and not sacrifice. And the title of our Lord Jesus Christ in his ministry, he is the lover of sinner and tax collector. He is the lover of sinner and tax collector. Actually, harshness will be punished harshly. If we are dealing harshly, then our punishment will be harsh too. Luke chapter 12, from verse 45 to 48. But if that servant says in his heart, my master is delaying his coming, and begins to beat the male and female servants, and to eat and drink and be drunk. So to beat, he is dealing harshly with his class. And your class are the children of God. So when you are dealing harshly with somebody, you are dealing harshly with the children of God whom he put in your trust. And begin to eat and drink and be drunk. I can be drunk with my own values, with my own rules, with my own commandments, when I see that I'm in control and I'm forcing my rules on my commandment. This actually can make me like a drunk. The master of that servant will come on a day when he is not looking for him, and at an hour when he is not aware, and will cut him in two and appoint him his portion with unbelievers. Tarfin, there are levels in punishment as there are levels in rewards. The sin of Sodom and Gomorrah was a sin of homosexuality. The sin of Kafr Nahum and Chorazin was sin of what? Unbelief, because he did not believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. فَلَمَا رَبِّنَا قَالْ إِنِّ Sodom and Gomorrah will have a better condition on the day of judgment than Kafr Nahum and Chorazin. ده معناها إيه؟ معناها which is severer, the punishment for the homosexuals or the punishment of the unbeliever? Which one will be severer? The unbeliever. The unbeliever, their punishment is severer than the non-repentant homosexual. طيب تعالوا بقى شوفوا هنا الخادم اللي هو deals harshly. His punishment like what? Like the unbelievers. بيقول كده, and appoint him his portion with the unbeliever. يبقى we can conclude in the punishment of a person who deals harshly with his class will be the same, will be severer than the punishment of the unrepentant homosexual. Because احنا احيانا كده بنقول, yeah, No, homosexuality دي حاجة وحشة وبايخ. Oh yeah, it's a sin. But maybe we never realize it, that the punishment of unkind servant will be severer than a punishment of unrepentant homosexual. And appoint him his portion with the unbeliever. And that servant who knew his master's will and did not prepare himself to do according to his will shall be beaten with many stripes. We know what is our master's will. Al-Qaeda, I desire mercy and not sacrifice. That's his will. So now we know his will. But if we don't do accordingly, he said he will be beaten with many stripes and severe punishment. But he who did not know, yet committed things deserving of stripes, shall be beaten with few. Maybe my students, they are not doing what's right, and I'm angry with them. Maybe they don't know the will of God as we know it. So their punishment will be less than my punishment, because I know the will of God, but I don't walk accordingly. Saint Peter gives advice to the priests. And by the way, today in the catechesis that, or the commandment that Sayyidina Araha to Abuna, ودي بنقراها مع كل كاهن جديد في يوم رسامته, taken from 1 Peter chapter 5, بيقول, shepherd the flock of God which is among you, serving as overseer, not by compulsion but willingly, not for dishonest gain but eagerly, nor as being lords over those who entrusted you. Don't act as a lord, don't act as a master and they are your servants, but being examples to the flock. You need actually to be example in patience, in kindness, in mercy to the flock. St. Paul to the clergy of Ephesus, we read it in Acts chapter 20. He gave them a final word before going to Jerusalem. وقالهم كده, for I know this, that after my departure, savage wolves will come in among you, not sparing the flock. بالعربي ولا يشفقون على الرعية. يعني there is emphasis here how we should be compassionate, how we should be loving, how we should be kind, not sparing the flock. And from among yourselves men will rise up speaking perverse things to draw away the disciples after themselves. One of the very important facts we need to remember, what's mentioned in Ezekiel chapter 34, verse 4, 5, 7 to 10. خل بالكو, there are some words that I highlighted or I made it bold. These are five categories of people, and we have responsibility toward these five categories. بيقول, the weak you have not strengthened, nor have you healed those who are sick, nor bound up the broken, nor brought back what was driven away, nor sought what was lost, but with force and cruelty you have ruled them. Who are the weak? The weak is person still growing in his spiritual life. Like, he's healthy, but like children, when they are growing, they are still weak physically. I'm speaking about physical weakness. They are healthy, but because they are children, they are weak. فممكن يكون في ناس in my class lest they started their spiritual journey. So they are infant or children in Christ. Or maybe a person who just joined the church recently. These are the weak. I should not deal with them by force and cruelty, but I should deal with them with compassion and strengthen them. The second group, the sick. The sick, these are people in the church, but they are sick with certain illness. They mean old sexual immorality, drugs, anger, violence, whatever. Our responsibility toward the sick, not again to deal with them with force and cruelty, but we need actually to seek their healing, how to help them to be healed. The third group are the broken. Broken, those actually who faced certain disaster in their life, like loss of loved one, like مثلاً diagnosis with terminal illness. واحد مثلاً يقول لك أنا بابا جاله كانسر. أو يقول لك أنا والدي توفى وهو في سن صغير, middle school. فدولت are broken with all, ولو مثلاً دخلوا in a financial crisis. These people are broken, and our responsibility for them to bind them up and to support them during this time of brokenness. وبعدين يقول لك nor brought back, اللي هو بقى fourth group, nor brought back those who were driven away. Driven away, يعني الناس اتطردت. يعني يمكن أنا أجي الكنيسة حد عملني وحش بطلت أجي الكنيسة. ممكن أجي الكنيسة أحس إن أنا I'm not welcomed فبطل أجي الكنيسة. يعني many people actually stopped coming to the church because they felt unwelcomed. خادم مدارس أحد اتعامل معه وحش, الشعب did not welcome them, did not accept them, so they feel they have no place in the church. So they are driven away. We have a responsibility toward these people, and to bring them back, mission to deal with them with force and cruelty. وآخر مجموعة, those who are lost. Lost either because of philosophies, مثلا الناس اللي بيقعدوا يقروا كتير في الآخر turn to be atheist, or those مثلا ابتدوا يروح denominations تانية, somebody يعني deceived them وقال لهم ان الأرثوذكس دي is not the right way, وابتدى يسحبهم لكنائس تانية أو other denominations. So these are lost. Again, we have responsibility to seek for the lost. The priests in Israel, these five groups did not deal with them with compassion. Rather, they dealt with them with force and cruelty. That's why the Lord told them, so they were scattered because there was no shepherd. ممكن تلاقي ولادنا ما بيجوش, they are scattered because we did not deal with them with compassion and love. They were scattered because there was no shepherd, and they become food for all the beasts of the field when they were scattered. يعني ايه beasts بقى, شياطين, شيطان الاثيزم, على شيطان الهوموسيكشواليتي, على شيطان الدرجز, على شيطان الترانجندرزم. All these, the beasts of the field, وولادنا بقوا food for all, يعني the beasts of the field. شوف بقى ربنا يقول لهم إيه. Therefore, you shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. As I live, says the Lord God, surely, because my flock became a prey, and my flock became food for every beast of the field, because there was no shepherd, nor did my shepherds search for my flock, but the shepherds fed themselves and did not feed my flock. Therefore, O shepherds, hear the word of the Lord. Thus says the Lord God, behold, I am against the shepherds. كلمة صعبة. مين يحتمل أن ربنا يبقى ضده؟ I am against the shepherds, and I will require my flock at their hands. I will cause them to cease feeding the sheep, and the shepherds shall feed themselves no more. For I will deliver my flock from their mouth, that they may go no longer be food for them. ده بيبين لنا برضو خطورة وأهمية how to deal with our class and students with compassion and kindness. Then نيجي بقى للسؤال how to deal with them. How to deal with them. Number one, examine your motive honestly. هل أنت angry and you are seeking vengeance or you are seeking treatment? As I told you about the sinner of Corinth, St. Paul, even in his discipline and the excommunication, he was seeking treatment, that his soul may be saved in the day of the Lord. فأنت لما تتنرفز على واحد ولا تاخد موقف شديد منه ولا to give him harsh discipline ولا تبقى متضايق منه, examine your motive. Why? Why you are actually angry? Why انت شخطت فيه? Why you dealt harsh with him? Are you doing this from therapeutic point of view? Or are you doing just كده انت you express your anger and your vengeance? وقبل ما تلومهم اسأل نفسك, did I serve them well? هل أنا افتقدتهم كويس؟ هل أنا حطيتهم على الطريق الروحي كويس؟ ما هم دولت مسؤوليتنا. يعني احنا if we did not visit them well, if we did not actually show them the way of the Lord, هيعرفوا منين؟ يعني before you judge them, ask yourself, did I serve them well ولا لا؟ في كتاب انطلاق الروح في شابتر كده, لو انت عايز تعرف يعني ايه خدمتهم كويس, في قصة كتبها البابا شنود اسمها وحدث في تلك الليلة, عملوها موفي وكتاب مترجم انجليزي The Release of the Spirit. يعني it will be a good homework for all of you to go and read this chapter to understand what does it mean to serve them well, because the servant in this story, he thought that he served his class well, but in the confrontation with the angel taught him that many, many things he could have done and he didn't do it. So before thinking about disciplining them, ask yourself, did I serve my class well or not? Bardo, we need to be sensitive. يعني don't punish or discipline somebody publicly. خصوصا الولاد اللي هم adolescent بيهتموا في المرحلة دي جدا جدا with their self-esteem and self-image. لما تشخص في ولد publicly وتهينه قصاد بقية الكلاس, انت you are destroying his self-image and his self-esteem. وبرضو الولاد الصغيرين while they are growing up, لما بتشخط فيهم بتخليه يبقى خواف كده, ما عندوش ثقة في نفسه. ف we need, فاكر احنا خدناه في درس الأحد, كان يقولوا لنا لو انت مثلا هتشد ودان ولد ولا هتقول له كده انت عملت كده حاجة غلط ولا كده, make sure ان انت مش angry من جوه, and make sure انك بتعمل كده وانت are smiling. لو these two requirements مش موجودين, ما يعني don't the discipline. لأن ما بقاش من جوه متغاظ منه angry, ما بعملهاش out of anger, وفي نفس الوقت بعملها in a smiling way عشان عايز أقول أنت عملت حاجة غلط, بس بقولها له يعني in a gentle way. برضو لو انت كخادم في مدارس احد before making a decision or a discipline تقول له ما تجيش الاسبوع الجاي مش تشترك في الكورال مش تشترك في كذا consult with Sunday school coordinator consult with أبونا يعني don't make a list you are wrong يعني maybe انت acting out of anger ف get advice from أمين الخدمة from أبونا before making يعني a final decision. لما تيجي مثلا تعمل discipline فكر في حاجة therapeutic to save the spirit in the day of the Lord. معناها ايه حاجة therapeutic مثلا ممكن ولد شائي فمثلا تديله كتاب calmness الهدوء بتاع قداسة البابا شنود تقول له انا عايزك تقرأ الكتاب ده وتعمل summary لي وتبعت لي summary دي مثلا في 3 صفحات 4 صفحات يمكن الكتاب يلمس قلبه ولد مثلا عايش بعيد عن ربنا in sexual immorality can give him مثلا the كتاب the life of repentance and purity حياة التوبة والنقاوة تديله شابتر تقول له اقرأ الشابتر ده ولخصه واكتبه لي في ورقتين او تديله عايزة يسمعها تقول لي اكتب لي ملخص العايزة دي يعني دي there are therapeutic discipline that will help him تقول له مثلا انا عايزك تجيب لي وانت بتقرأ في كتاب مقدس كل الايات اللي تتكلم عن anger كل الايات تتكلم عن ان احنا to love one another لو واحد عمال بيتخانق مع اخواته في الكلاس I want you to find مثلا to read the gospel of Matthew وتكتب لي الايات اللي هي بتتكلم على how we should love one another all these are discipline that actually can be therapeutic also you shouldn't have partiality يعني ايه partiality يعني مثلا لو الطفل ده عمل او الشاب ده عمل المشكلة دي وواحد تاني عمل نفس المشكلة but because I am comfortable and I like this person يعني خلاص I will let it go but if this person عمل نفس المشكلة no I will discipline him then you have a partiality you have a bias انت because you are not comfortable for this, with this person for some reason or another that's why you deal with him يعني firmly and harshly while if some other يعني another person did the same thing maybe you would not actually consider any discipline at all كلنا عندنا some favoritism احيانا يعني فلما يجيك واحد مثلا ان انت you favor them in the class لما واحد تاني يعمل مشكلة وتحس ان انت you need to discipline him ask yourself about the person اللي هو انت you favor قول طب لو البيرسون ده he made the same issue how I'm gonna react لو react ان انا I will let it go then you need to let it go otherwise you have partiality otherwise the motive ان انت to discipline this person is not to save the spirit but because you don't like him because you are not comfortable with him Always, you need to keep the balance between love and control. Love, يعني يقول لك justice and mercy have kissed each other. This balance is very important. When you discipline somebody, you need to do it in a loving way. In a loving way. If you show control without love, then it is cruelty. If you show love without control, then but the hypocrisy. For you need to keep the balance between love and control. And as St. Paul followed up after the discipline by sending Titus to them, you need to follow up after any discipline. يعني حكيتها كذا مرة أنا مرة اتطردت من مدرسة الأحد ومرة من خدمة الشمامسة. بس في المرتين الخدام جم سألوا عليا ما سابونيش كده يعني جم ويصلحوني وجابوا لي هدية ويعني سألوا علي مش طردوني وخلاص وسابوني كده يعني. ف you need to follow up. يعني لو انت مثلا زعقت الواحد ولا جرحت مشاعره ولا حاجة زي كده روح اسأل عليه طمن عليه شوف أخباره ايه check on him don't just leave him يجي بقى ما يجيش. وانا في المرتين اللي بحكي لكم عليهم جم في نفس اليوم انا الخدام بتوعي في نفس اليوم جم البيت وزاروني and checked on me. فيعني حتى ما تنتظرش الاسبوع اللي بعديه وما ينفعش حتى مكالمة تليفون. لو زعلت واحد روح له واسأل عليه وشرح له ليه حصل منك كده النهاردة يعني. ازاي تسيب واحد يعني قلبه مجروح ينام كده من غير ما تطمنه يعني. So in conclusion we need to be kind. Any discipline should be done with love and the goal should be to save the spirit in the day of the Lord. Ask the Lord to help you to overcome your personal issues if there are personal issues. And if you hurt somebody, be courageous enough to apologize and to ask for forgiveness. And we need to remember all the time, we are servants, not masters. Don't lord it over the flock. We are servant, called to wash the feet of the people, not masters. Glory be to God forever and ever. Amen.